Also kind of brief. My mother, well, my grandmother knew somebody that she really wanted my mother to be friends with. And my mother, not being a very social person, didn't really want to have any friends, but because her mother made her be friends with this person, that's how she found out about the Baha'i faith, because this other person was a Baha'i. She was really the only other, or one of the very few Baha'is in our small town in Western Colorado where I grew up. And so as a young child, because my mother was learning about the Baha'i faith, we as children would go over to her house and have children's classes. So at a very young age, I learned about the Baha'i principles, but I never felt super like a super spiritual person, and didn't see much about how that could relate to my life until I was much older. So I became a Baha'i when I was 16, and then again when I was 26, after some other explorations when I was at Stanford in a very materialistic scientific environment doing my PhD research. So yeah, it was a two-pronged process. First, spiritual attraction and emotional attraction to the community, and then an intellectual attraction to the deeper questions in life.